I think, you know, Marcus Smith, the creative director, and I were both here for Resistance One. A lot of the team was here for Resistance One.
We wanted to make a game where we allowed the player to choose the way they play the game, and absolutely the best way to do that is having all your weapons at your disposal.
I just think we just started feeling more comfortable with the idea of, like, we can be our own game. We don't have to do what every other military shooter is doing right now.
That it's just kind of in our company culture at this point to come up with crazy weapons.
It's so hard, like, always thinking of trying to think of new guns. I mean, between Ratchet and Resistance, I don't know how many guns have been through the series. What is going to be different? What else is left? What have we not done?
A lot of times we will go back to the Ratchet weapons and say, okay, it's kind of like this weapon, but we want to obviously make it different for this. The best thing about having such a lineage of having exotic weapons is we can go back through our kind of library of effects and library of functionality and say, what worked, what didn't work, and what can we bring to the table here? The reason that we really went with the upgrade system was, in Ratchet 2 you had a lot of different weapons, and we discovered that people would tend to kind of have their favorite and just go with it. And what the upgrade system did on a gameplay side was, you kind of wanted to experience all the different weapons because you wanted to upgrade them as you went along. So by doing